In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
I welcome you to Mass on this, the memorial of St. Thomas Aquinas, priest and doctor of the Church. We're offering this Mass for the repose of the soul of Dennis Driscoll, and of your charity at the same time this morning, the funeral in St. Mary's Star of the Sea of Peter Ratu, who was a parishioner here but did have long-standing connections to Star of the Sea and Fairlight. So eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May they rest in peace.
Amen. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which is used as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Almighty ever-living God, who willed that through water, the fountain of life and the source of purification, even souls should be cleansed, and receive the gift of eternal life. Be pleased, we pray, to bless this water by which we seek protection on this day, O Lord. Renew the living spring of your grace within us, and grant that by this water we may be defended from all ills of spirit and body, and so approach you with hearts made clean, and worthily receive your salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. We humbly ask you, Almighty God, be pleased in your faithful love to bless this salt you have created. For it was you who commanded the prophet Elisha to cast salt into water, that impure water might be purified. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that wherever this mixture of salt and water is sprinkled, every attack of the enemy may be repulsed, and your Holy Spirit may be present to keep us safe at all times. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of his kingdom. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who made St. Thomas Aquinas outstanding in his zeal for holiness, and his study of sacred doctrine, grant us, we pray, that we may understand what he taught and imitate what he accomplished, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God for ever and ever. Amen. Amen.
David, however,
remained in Jerusalem. It happened towards evening, when David had risen from his couch and was strolling on the palace roof, that he saw from the roof a woman bathing. The woman was very beautiful. David made inquiries about this woman and was told, "Why, that is Bathsheba, Eliam's daughter, the wife of Uriah the Hittite." Then David sent messages and brought her. She came to him and he slept with her. She then went home again. The woman conceived and sent word to David, "I am with child." Then David sent Joab a message, "Send me Uriah the Hittite." Whereupon Joab sent Uriah to David. When Uriah came into his presence, David asked after Joab and the army and how the war was going. David then said to Uriah, "Go down to your house and enjoy yourself." Uriah left the palace and was followed by a present from the king's table. Uriah, however, slept by the palace door with his master's bodyguard and did not go down to his house. This was reported to David. Uriah, they said, did not go down to his house. The next day, David invited him to eat and drink in his presence and made him drunk. In the evening, Uriah went out and lay on his couch with his master's bodyguard, but he did not go down to his house. Next morning, David wrote a letter to Joab and sent it by Uriah. In the letter he wrote, "Station Uriah in the thick of the fight, and then fall back behind him so that he may be struck down and die." Joab, then besieging the town, posted Uriah in a place where he knew there were fierce fighters. The men of the town sallied out and engaged Joab. The army suffered casualties, including some of David's bodyguard, and Uriah the Hittite was killed too. The word of the Lord. Have mercy on us, Lord, for we have sinned. Have mercy on me, God, in your kindness. In your compassion, blot out my faults. O wash me more and more from my guilt, and cleanse me from my sin. My offences truly I know them. My sin is always before me. Against you, you alone have I sinned. What is evil in your sight I have done. That you may be justified when you give sentence, and be without reproach when you judge. O see, in guilt I was born, a sinner was I conceived. Make me hear rejoicing with gladness, that the bones you have crushed may thrill. From my sins turn away your face, and blot out all my guilt.
Alleluia. This is what the kingdom of God is like. A man throws seed on the land. Night and day while he sleeps, when he is awake, the seed is sprouting and growing. How, he does not know. Of its own accord, the land produces first the sheat, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And when the crop is ready, he loses no time. He starts to reap because the harvest has come. He also said, what can we say the kingdom of God is like? What parable can we find for it? It is like a mustard seed, which at the time of its sowing in the soil is the smallest of all the seeds on earth. Yet once it is sown, it grows into the biggest shrub of them all and puts out big branches so that the birds of the air can shelter in its shade. Using many parables like these, he spoke the word to them so far as they were capable of understanding it. He would not speak to them except in parables, but he explained everything to his disciples when they were alone. The Gospel of the Lord. King David, the Lord's anointed, commits multiple mortal sin. The Book of Chronicles will later gloss over David's offences, but here Samuel spells them out. Any leader should know that high office brings a greater scrutiny of their actions. David acts like Adam before him. Despite all God has given him, he wants more. He commits four sins. He covets his neighbor's wife. He commits adultery. He commits deception. And he commits murder. The text also implies Bathsheba acts like Eve, provocatively bathing within sight of the king, enticing him to her, thinking very little, it seems, of her husband's death. They have let their passions run amok, not practicing spiritual disciplines such as custody of the eyes. Clement of Alexandria wrote, our appetites are inflamed by the sensuality of the gaze, and our eyes, used to looking lustfully at our neighbour because we are so idle, spark impure desires. And indeed, that saying that the devil makes work for idle hands. So instead we should be at work, serving our brothers and sisters in need. The parable of the mustard seed teaches us that we should spare no effort in support of the kingdom. Our announcement of the good news in word and in deed will yield much fruit, a satisfaction greater and more sustainable than our wayward passions can ever offer us. We keep a crucifix nearby to remind us to keep our passions in check and to unite them to the passion of Christ. This helps us to avoid those near occasions of sin. However, the same devil who tempted Adam and Eve, David and Bathsheba, tempts us also into thinking that this seed of the divine life is so small that it will never amount to anything. Fortunately, the mercy of God always prevails, and even King David finds his way again. After he repents, he is granted within marriage this time another son, Solomon, who will be a wise king and start the messianic hope. And this hope is evident in us when we make a good confession. God's grace brings pardon, but it also offers strength against future temptations. We are reinvigorated with the life of the Spirit who inspires us and leads us home to the kingdom. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice which we gladly present on the feast day of Blessed Thomas Aquinas be pleasing to you, O God, for taught by him we too give ourselves entirely to you in praise, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Thomas Aquinas, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Thomas Aquinas, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Richard our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom we have summoned before you, in your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servants Dennis and Peter, whom you have called from this world to yourself, for on the day he reunites with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
From heaven and with him and in him, above Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen.
At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And
for the first time in 2 years, let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Through Christ the teacher and Lord, instruct those who feed with Christ the living bread, that on the feast day of Blessed Thomas Aquinas, they may learn your truth and express it in works of charity. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I keep Father Rajesh in your prayers. He's gone back to India for a little bit of a holiday and also for a family wedding. Pray he comes back safely and doesn't have to isolate for COVID because someone gives it to him on the plane or something like that. I look forward, therefore, to celebrating all five public masses this weekend. Pray that I manage to celebrate all five with the same joy as I do the first. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thank you,
God. We just keep up the good practice of keeping the church clean and by doing our place before we